And to the massacre in Norway, authorities began today to publicly identify some of the victims of the Friday attacks. So far, the list includes three from the bomb blast in Oslo, where eight were killed, and just one from the shooting at the political youth camp on the island of Utøya. 68 are known to have died there. Some are still missing. We have a report from Carl Dinnen of Independent Television News in Oslo.
It's just a wristband, but it bears the name Utøya. It's from the camp. For Tonya, it says, "I was there. I survived." Yet Anders Behring Breivik had stood within feet of her.
He came into the next room next to us, and he was just on the other side of the door.
How did you know he was in the next room? What was he doing?
You heard the sound of his feet hitting the, like a movie in a way. And he was shooting, and then he stopped shooting. And we realized he was empty, and he was going to fix it. And then we realized that this is the time to jump out of the window. It was pretty high, but it's the best thing I've ever done, jumping out of that window.
Tonya escaped the island with her life, but she says she knew every single one of the people who did not make it.
Some of them I knew very well, and some of them I have not met so often, but they are still close friends and mean so much to me. So yeah, it's hard to bear. It's very hard to bear.
Does it seem real?
No.
Images of the missing and the dead smile out from Norway's newspapers. Many more will appear as they are announced in the coming days. The lawyer who must defend the man responsible says he is most likely insane.
Has he shown any remorse or any regret for what he did?
He said it was necessary to start a war here in Europe and throughout the Western world. So he's sorry that it was necessary, but it was necessary, he says.
Was he expecting to survive and be arrested?
No.
He expected he would be killed or that he would kill himself?
He expected to be killed.
He also told us Breivik had taken drugs to stay alert. As Norwegians come together in grief, there are questions about whether the killer could have been stopped. The head of Norway's domestic security service admitted they'd seen his name, but says they did not have a clear picture.
Was the decision not to investigate him after he came on this list the right decision?
This was not a list as such. This was just a list that he had been in contact and paid a very small amount of about £12 to this. We had nothing further. And if we had put him in our database, I think half of Norway would have been in our database, and that's not that sort of country we are.
Norwegian intelligence are reviewing procedures, but say they could not have stopped Breivik. As for Tonya, she is determined to return one day to Utøya.
I want to go back. It's my island. It's still my island. It's still my paradise.
She says then and only then will she feel able to remove her wristband.
The police force in Oslo continued to face criticism today over its response to the shooting spree on Utøya. It took 90 minutes to reach the gunman, in part because the department doesn't own a helicopter and its boat broke down en route to the island. This evening, police detonated explosives found on a farm leased by the gunman. They believed he used fertilizer as the main ingredient in the Oslo bomb.